Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to this celebration of life service for Art Martin. Art passed away in the wee hours of the morning on Good Friday, and quite quickly after he was diagnosed with stage 4 lung cancer. And so we're grateful to celebrate the life of Art and to bless his future burial space, but that certainly to usher him in with blessing as he goes forth into his next life. We begin this afternoon with a prayer. Would you please pray with me? O God, who gave us birth, you are ever more ready to hear than we are to pray. You know our needs before we ask and our ignorance in asking. Give to us now your grace, that as we shrink before the mystery of death, we may see the light of eternity. Speak to us once more your solemn message of life and of death. Help us to live as those who are prepared to die. And when our days here are accomplished, enable us to die as those who go forth to live, so that living or dying, our life may be in you, and that nothing in life or in death will be able to separate us from your great love in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Bruce McDaniel and I got together last week to discuss what scripture reading might be appropriate for Art. And as Bruce, I'm sure, is going to be telling you in a few minutes, Art was somehow just enamored with airplanes and this idea of flight. And so we picked out the reading from Psalm 91 and portions of it. You who live in the shelter of the Most High, who abide in the shadow of the Almighty, will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For God will deliver you from the snare of the fowler, from the deadly pestilence. God will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. God of faithfulness is a shield and a buckler. You will not fear the terror of the night, or the arrow that flies by day, or the pestilence that stalks in darkness, or the destruction that wastes at noonday. Those who love me I will deliver. I will protect those who know my name. And when they call to me, I will answer them. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue them and honor them. With long life, I will satisfy them and show them my salvation. There are some, but probably fewer than I would like to think, that had such a perfect attendance record as Art and June Martin. I would get a call either earlier in the week or that morning, Sunday morning, that they were either away or that they weren't feeling well and wouldn't be in worship. Now, near as we can tell, June and Art started to attend Covenant sometime around 1972 after they were married, which I did the math. I know that's hard for me, but I did the math, which means they listened to nearly 2,700 sermons. And I would hope that in all of those sermons and those worship services, that the one thing Art and June took away was how God was their rescuer, their protector, how nothing in life could separate them from the love of God in Jesus. The day before Art died, I visited him in the hospital. And he hadn't found out his diagnosis yet, but I think he knew. And he wasn't afraid. I was with Art the last time he saw June in the nursing home, and it was in the midst of the worst of COVID. So we couldn't stay long. And I will never forget how happy they were to see each other. Theirs was a good marriage. Art was a loving and devoted husband. One of the most tender images of God as a rescuer and protector is this image of being lifted up on eagle's wings, strong and mighty, majestic, magnificent. And as Bruce will tell you, as I said, Art loved the idea of flying. And his model airplane collection was, I'm sure, unmatched. And it made Bruce and I both think of the poem High Flight by John Gillespie McGee. Oh, I have slipped the surly bonds of earth and danced the skies on laughter-silvered wings. Sunward I've climbed and joined the tumbling mirth of sun-split clouds and done 100 things you have not dreamed of. Wheeled and soared and swung high in the sunlit silence. Hovering there, I've chased the shouting wind along and flung my eager craft through footless halls of air. Up, up the long, delirious, burning blue, I've topped the windswept heights with easy grace, where never lark or even eagle flew. And while with silent, lifting mind I've trod the high, untrespassed sanctity of space, put out my hand and touched the face of God. That's what I think Art did in the wee hours of the Good Friday morning. He put out his hand and touched the face of God. Amen.
Well, I'm happy this morning to offer a few words about my friend Art Martin. I suppose many of us, when we think of Art, think June and Art.
Yes.
They were a pair, inseparable. And as Pastor Ann mentioned, their time here at Covenant goes back many decades, which is interesting because one time Art said to me that he was a confirmed Catholic. Mm-hmm. Apparently that's how he started out in life, but obviously he found a home here. I got to know June and Art when I learned that June had lost a son in the Vietnam War. Now, he was not Art's son. This was June's son from a previous marriage. But Art was very supportive of June when the local chapter of Vietnam Veterans of America welcomed June into their hearts. They honored her as our local Gold Star mother.
Hmm.
And for many years, I used to take June and Art to the chapter's annual dinner in the spring. And that was a time we really enjoyed together. And on Memorial Day, if you went to the celebration at Highland Park, mm-hmm. you'd always see June and Art on their folding chairs sitting down front.
Mm-hmm.
So Art was very supportive of June's connection to the veteran community. He was also very supportive in another way. June had some serious medical issues, mm-hmm. and sometimes she needed a lot of care and help. And Art was always there to help her and support her the best he could. Yeah. He was a very devoted husband. Mm-hmm. In December of 2020, June passed away. And it had been very frustrating for Art because the COVID restrictions had limited his ability to visit her. Mm-hmm. That was a very difficult time, I think, for both of them. But a few months after June passed away, Art moved to an apartment in Greece that's part of Episcopal Senior Life. Oh. Art did not have a car, he did not drive, and I had been taking him to food stores for some time. When our church opened up in-person worship in February of 2021, Art said he wanted to come. So he came. And I don't think that we missed an awful lot of Sundays.
No.
He really wanted to be here. As Art and I drove around, Art liked to talk. And very much so. I learned a lot of his stories. I found out that he had grown up somewhere in the area of the Thousand Islands. He had a grandfather who was French-Canadian and had a Native American wife.
Oh.
Art served in the Navy and had sailed on the Great Lakes. And in his earlier years, he used to play the guitar. Art knew a lot about a lot of things, and he had a lot of stories and opinions. Now, if you ever had the occasion to visit June and Art in their apartment on Portland Court, you would know that Art liked to make model airplanes. He had hundreds of them. He had a couple of display cases, and eventually he took them when he moved to Greece, full of models. Most of them fairly small, a few of them larger. And he was in a model building club, and on Thursday nights he would go to build meetings so they could get together and work on their models and share their insights. I used to put together plastic models when I was younger, but nothing like Art. He was a perfectionist. He really knew how to make these little airplanes look accurate in terms of what they were, and he knew all about airplanes. Anything you wanted to ask about the different models and the different kinds of aircraft in different countries, air forces, he knew a lot about that kind of stuff. A lot of his models were very accurate, but Art had a sense of humor, and sometimes he got creative. And I know you can't see this from where you are, but here is one of his models, and if I can describe it for you, the front of this model he fashioned into a shark's face. You probably can't see it, but he's got a shark's mouth, the mouth is open with the teeth showing, and then the tail is a shark's fin. So, and he called this Shark Attack. So here is his model, Shark Attack. He also had one in which the whole front of the plane was a huge lizard's face. So he did some funny things with his models, and he was able to make those modifications. He was a real problem solver. He could figure out solutions to things. He was really an amazing guy. And I'm really grateful that over the last couple of years, I had the opportunity to get to know him better. He was an amazing person.
What happened to the models?
I don't know.
Oh.
There was some talk about maybe some of the people in the model club would want some of them. I hope that happened.
Yeah, someone who would appreciate them.
Right.
Yeah, okay. Well, that does sound like Art. Art's ashes are with a niece, and they will be scattering the ashes up in the Adirondacks at their annual family reunion this summer. But it is important for us to pray a blessing on that site, wherever it may be. So as we commit Art's spirit to eternal rest, I offer this prayer to consecrate his final resting place and to commit his spirit to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty God, in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to his final resting place Arthur Martin. We commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord maketh his face to shine upon him and to be gracious to him and to give him peace. Amen. So having committed Arthur's spirit to eternal rest, we now say farewell and commend him to be at peace as he travels in his next spiritual journey, walking a path lighted by the one who gives us all life in his name. And together the people of God say, Amen. The Lord's Prayer. Yes, we do want to sing. I skipped right over that, because it would be appropriate if we stood and sang with Kathy on Eagle's Wings. Kathy's going to sing the verses, and we will join in the refrain.
You who dwell in the shelter of our God, who abides in the shadow of life, say to our God, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and God will raise you up on eagle's wings. Thank you.
peace, Art. I invite you to be seated for the postlude, the Lord's Prayer.
Amen.